Good morning and happy Easter. I just want to make a quick announcement that we have so many people coming today. God bless that. But can you squish in and make room for people to fill in the pews if possible? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good morning and happy Easter. Please rise and join us in Jesus Christ is risen today.
Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
We glorify you.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them,
They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him. So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. When I put on my alb this morning, it was still wet from all the baptisms we did the night before. 33 baptisms, 33 confirmations, 33 first communions, and 7 marriages. That was pretty awesome, right? I mean, we're clapping for them, but I hope they're sleeping in this morning, because I'm not sleeping in, but I hope they are. But Easter Vigil is such a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Mass. It's like the granddaddy of all Masses. It's like the Rose Bowl of Masses, right? And it's like, it like has everything. It has all the readings. It has all the liturgical things. And all of it points towards one victorious moment that Jesus Christ rose from the dead. That is the fundamental truth that our entire faith hinges on. When I chose our Paschal candle for this year, I always look at the catalog and they have all these cool designs. But the one that I wanted to choose this year was about the resurrection. Why do you search for the living among the dead? In Luke is what's inscribed in our Paschal candle. The Paschal candle is the one thing that actually really symbolizes to us the resurrection in a profound way. The light overcomes the darkness. And the Paschal candle will be lit every day in Easter. 10 more days than what we had in Lent. Because we are a people of profound joy. I'd like to share with you a couple of the prayers that we say at the Easter Vigil about the Paschal candle and its symbolism. It's prayers that a lot of times people in the Easter Vigil even miss because it's outside, and sometimes people can't even hear what the priest is praying. But this is how Easter Sunday begins. Dear brothers and sisters, on this most sacred night in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters scattered throughout the world to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we shall have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Then here's the prayer. O God, who through your Son bestowed upon the faithful the fire of your glory, sanctify this new fire, we pray, and grant that by these Paschal celebrations, we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires that with minds made pure, we may attain festivities of unending splendor. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. A lot of times we try to think of, like, what would heaven look like? And that's a speculative thing. I don't know. I don't think any priest knows. The Pope doesn't know. We don't know yet. Well, maybe some dead popes know, right? But unless you're there, you don't know. But what we have here is where you may attain festivities of unending splendor. And we're saying this prayer as there is one light in the midst of all the darkness that surrounds it. And we say this prayer as Christians during all of our times of trial and persecution and suffering and weakness and illness and, yes, even death. That in the midst of all this darkness, the light of Jesus Christ gives us hope. That there is more than just this. There is more than just the material world. That God has something wonderful in store for us. Festivities of unending splendor. And what that means I don't know. But it will be awesome. It will be life, because the tomb is empty. I don't know how many of you guys had a chance to do the Triduum, Holy Thursday or Good Friday, but it's the 2 days of the year I get really German, right? Like, I bring the cloppers back. That's such a German thing. It's a totally made-up thing in Germany with the cloppers. You know, the bell is forbidden, and I'm like, no, we're going to bring out the clopper, and we clap them around and stuff like that. And Deacon Dell was even teasing me. It's like I had to work with an Irish priest, and I got to work with a German priest, you know? And the Germans have, like, this wonderful tradition that is very kind of unique, that every time something big happens in the church, like the godmother gives someone a candle. Like, we're way into candles. Germany is, like, way into candles. And I brought two candles that I think help us think about the Paschal mystery of Jesus Christ. And I have them at the altar, but they're the two candles my godmother got me at my diaconate ordination and my priestly ordination. And she was really, like, panicking about it, because it's like her godson became a priest. She wasn't expecting that. And so she had to, like, step up her candle game, right? The first one has a picture of, looks like a sun, it could be Eucharistic host, and a path, because where I'm from in Germany is the Jakobsweg. It's the Camino. It's the portion of Germany that'll eventually go to Spain. And in it, for my priestly ordination, it says, Christus ist unser Weg, which means Christ is our way. And when she gave me this for my priestly ordination, I thought it was such a fitting gift for a priest, because Christ is not something that is just my gift. The Paschal gift that we received last night, resurrection, the promise of eternal life, is something that is shared. When we bring out the Paschal candle, we bring it out, and we always bring it out in times of community and vulnerability. After the Easter Sunday, it comes out for two reasons. Baptisms, when we baptize a baby. And there, you know, it's not the kids' faith that we're testing. It's actually the parents and the godparents. And we're actually telling them, are you going to raise this child in the faith? Do you actually make a promise to God that you're going to raise this child in the way of Christ? It's a remarkable sign that those baptized into Christ are baptized into His church. We are not like isolated churches walking around. You're not going to be alone in heaven.
We're going to be there whether you like it or not, right? The other time the paschal candle is brought out is at funerals throughout the year. And there, at funerals, we remember those promises that we made at our baptism, those promises that we share in the life and the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And there, at our funeral, we have to trust our brother and sister to carry us in for one last Mass. Christ is our salvation. We are here on the first day of the week, the day of the resurrection, because Christ came to save us. That person that sometimes we might judge, or that person that what we might be mad at, Christ loves infinitely. So much so that he poured out his heart for them. Christ desires them to be with them in heaven. We should too. We should share in that desire. Forgive our brothers and sisters and want to be united with all in heaven. This little one is a great one. It was given to me at my diaconal ordination. And my priestly ordination, I was super excited. I was just ready, right? My diaconal ordination, I was like really nervous. Like really nervous, right? Because at the diaconal ordination, that's when you make the promise of celibacy, and that's when you make the promise of simplicity, right? Like I was basically promising to God and the church and my mom and everybody who was there, that's like, I'm not going to have a wife, I'm not going to have kids, I'm not going to get paid much, right? Like I'm trusting in God in this profound way. And she gives me this candle and has a chalice and a cross and a, I don't know, it looks like a horseshoe thing. But she's my godmother. She can do whatever she wants, right? It's beautiful. It's beautiful. And in it, it says, Dein Glaube macht dich reich, PJN. Dein Glaube macht dich reich. Your faith makes you rich. One of the hardest things my family had to come to grips with when I became a priest was how little I got paid. They're so German. They actually came to me and they were like, are you sure you don't want to be a Lutheran priest? They get paid more. And I was like, guys, we're missing the boat. What makes us rich is the promise of Jesus Christ in the resurrection. Because when the paschal candle is lit, no matter what is in your bank account, we are all sons and daughters of the same Lord. And we all share in the same inheritance. We're all beggars for the grace of Jesus Christ. And the grace of Jesus Christ gives us a greater rich and a greater treasure than anything we can get in this world. This phrase, Dein Glaube macht dich reich, comes from Father Joseph Nardini, who's a blessed and who's really, really, really popular in my part of Germany. And he was a saint. Well, he's not a saint yet, I'm sorry. He's blessed. He's a blessed that in the mid-19th century went to Pirmasens, Germany, and saw all this poverty around him. And so what he wanted to do was he wanted to actually start some orphanages. And he recruited these Franciscans of the poor, now known as kind of the Nardini sisters, and they actually started all these orphanages. And what was great, and one thing I love about Father Nardini, is he did not ask the bishop for permission. He just kind of did it. And eventually the bishop allowed it. I guess it's like better to ask forgiveness than permission. That's like what he did. But he invested everything in taking care of the orphan and the widow and the poor. So much so that in Permaissance, he was simply known as Father of the Poor. And this is his phrase. Dein Glaube macht dich reich. That poor orphan child that has no earthly mother or father, or that poor widow living in the streets, is immensely treasured by the promise of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Guys, he rose from the dead. Do you believe this? And if you believe it, where do you store your treasures? It's worth pondering as we renew our baptismal promises. Let us stand. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled upon us as a memorial of our baptism. May he graciously renew us, that we may remain faithful to the Spirit whom we have received. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God and the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty show? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord, for eternal life. Amen.
River.
Brothers and sisters, let us lift up our prayers to God who hears the cries of the poor.
For the church in this season of joy, may the Holy Spirit empower us to share the good news with all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who serve in the judicial system and in law enforcement, may the Lord guide them in the ways of justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who do not yet believe or understand, may the light of the risen Christ draw them to faith and truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, may we be drawn more deeply into personal relationship with Christ through his loving power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the hope of resurrection, may they rest in eternal peace in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and generous God, thank you for hearing our prayers. Answer them in your goodness, your mercy, and your love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Our offertory is Ye Sons and Daughters.
Our death today rose triumphant.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exalted with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say. Sorry. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with her blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint John the Baptist, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope and Oscar Bishop, the order bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you, and your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, and to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter into the house of the Lord, but only one word is spoken. For communion, those that are Catholic may receive communion. If you're not Catholic and you're here as a guest, you can come with your arms crossed to receive a blessing.
You also can
stay in your pew, whatever you feel more
comfortable. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us keep the feast with the unleavened bread of purity and truth. Alleluia. Give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy are you.
Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive honor and glory. Worthy are the ones who believe to receive the goodness of God. Worthy are
bread of life. Thank you.
Oh,
Just a...
Come over here. My mic is a...
My mic is not sharing in the Paschal joy this morning. All right? Just a reminder, we're still going to have the Easter extravaganza at 12:30. The sun should be out by then, or at least less clouds should be out. So, like, if the kids got to put on their little rain boots or something before then, let's do it. Because we have over 13,000 Easter eggs, and Father Tilly cannot eat that much. So I need help, all right? So 12:30, we have the Easter extravaganza. It is BYOB, bring your own basket, okay? So just remember that. And it'll be out in the center circle because it has better water drainage and those things, okay? The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Jesus is risen.
Jesus is risen. Let us sing praise to the ever-loving.
Happy Easter.